I'm joined by Jason and Dylan in the Bigfoot Academy to spotlight three different combinations that you can use on your Bigfoot rotary polisher to get high levels of quick, rapid defect removal. So in this coarse category, we have a traditional four-ply twisted wool pad in combination with the blue rotary compound, and that's gonna remove defects really quickly. Moving down the aggressive level just a little bit, but really boosting the finish is this merino cut and finish wool pad. So this doesn't have quite the level of aggressiveness as the twisted wool pad, but it's gonna leave a much better finish. And this is a really unique solution in this market. And then we have a traditional coarse blue foam cutting pad with the rotary blue compound. And that's gonna have probably the least amount of defect removal. We're really gonna put it to the test today, but it's gonna have the highest finish. And speaking of the test, I'm gonna have my helpers join me. What we did to prepare this hood was sand it with 1500 grit. This hood actually comes from a local vocational school and it has really, really, really tough industrial paint. We sanded it with 1500 grit, but we actually had to go over it three or four times just to get the sheen off. So we're not expecting to remove all of the defects. This paint's too hard for that, but what we are expecting is to give you guys at home a really good comparison between the twisted wool, the merino cut and finish wool, and the blue foam pads. So we're done polishing and we've got our results. And like we suspected in the beginning with this really hard paint and that really aggressive sand mark, we didn't expect to get out all the defects, but it gave us a good point of differentiation. In looking at the side that I did with the four ply twisted wool pad, it is as close to total defect removal as possible. But unfortunately, I can see a lot of surface holograms, right? Little linear repeating scratches in the surface that are gonna require a couple follow-up steps. And Dylan kind of give you a good look.
Yeah, no, that's definitely, I mean, it's what we expected, right? Because that type of pad is for mowing stuff down, but you're not expecting it to finish well. You just want the defects gone so you have a lighter defect to come back and address, right?
Super aggressive, but you're gonna have to follow with steps for sure.
So mine, the cut and finish, the merino wool, I'm actually really impressed with the amount of correction I was able to get out of it. I mean, close to, I'd say, the level that you got in terms of defect removal. But the difference is I don't have that pad mark. I don't have there is definitely a little bit of a buffer trail, but far less of that. I'd say a higher gloss for sure.
Mm-hmm.
I like just, and you could tell when we were using it too, the stability of this pad is just so much with that foam kind of interface. It's just so much more stable
smooth,
under the
yeah,
tools.
Smooth run.
It lends itself to kind of the flat pad polishing style. But yeah, no, I'm super, super impressed.
Couple little pigtails in there. Again, yeah. To be expected on this particular paint. But yeah, I would agree. I think in cut, I'd say the cut is 80 to 90%. Of this, but the finish
it is much better.
It's just almost not comparable.
Yep, yeah. Yep. And then Jason's section, which we gave him the least firepower in this whole comparison.
He did it on purpose. Jason's really good with the rotary.
So the progression here, we actually are getting improvement on finish, and as expected, you know, the foam delivered a bit better finish. However, not as aggressive of a cut on the sanding mark compared to these two pads, but it did a pretty good job.
Gloss, you have very shiny defects now, right? It couldn't cut out all of the defects, but it definitely put a lot of shine into it. So it definitely highlights what foam is gonna do for something on a rotary, which is produce gloss, mostly.
So yeah. 70, 80% defect removal, but much, much glossier than these other pads. So that, I didn't see anything here that was out of the ordinary, unexpected.
I think actually the merino wool pad, in terms of bridging that difference, was a little unexpected because the cut is that good and the finish is close to the foam. I mean, it's not there, but it's close.
And well, really, if I'm gonna take one pad, this would be it, for sure.
The best of both worlds, yeah. Right? Almost as much cut as that guy and almost as good as finish as that. And if I'm gonna grab a rotary tool for that purpose, I'm gonna get the closest to my goal with that pad of these three.
So I think the conclusion is clear. If you need mow down nuclear firepower to take out a deep scratch, or you're working on rock hard paint, maybe even gel coat, that's really gone far. this is your solution, but the drawback is multiple follow-up steps.
Yep.
Right? Going down a step.
Yeah, we'd say the cut and finish, the merino wool pad here gives you close to that kind of cut, maybe like you said, 80, 90% the level of cut of the twisted wool, but we've got a much higher potential for finish. So the defect that I have to chase at this point,
that is, range is huge.
Yeah, the range is massive. So I have a very, very light cleanup step in this area versus you might have to use something a little bit more aggressive on your side. Sure. And then obviously the foam comes in that finishing area.
And the ideal purpose for this foam would be paint on the soft side, maybe a really refined, high quality sanding mark.
3,000-5,000 grit, something in
that
world.
So, you know, or you really can use this as a second step for a real aggressive, you know, thing on gel coat or whatever. But yeah, just paint on the soft side. And if your emphasis is more on the finishing and the glossy, this would be the
choice. Great option. Less follow-up for sure with these two. Very cool. So I hope that this video has been helpful in kind of spotlighting and highlighting three different solutions in the Rupus Blue Course lineup on a rotary polisher. So you can kind of dial in the level of cut and finish you need for your next polishing project.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave us a comment below if this was useful, and be on the lookout for more Rupus product spotlight videos.